I'm Carol Angela Davis with your reality news check for Wednesday, the 28th of September, 2011. Your news and commentary will begin with your headlines. The first story, Eric Cantor's hypocrisy. Also, business is good over at this store. Plus, bad news for U.S. durable goods orders. Then in the auto industry, the U.S. delivers. The question is, for whom? Also, one millionaire says to Obama, please tax me. We'll tell you who he is. Then Iran says it's sending ships to the U.S. border. Also, is it true that Israelis want Israel to accept a U.N. decision on statehood? Also, a huge drug haul in Afghanistan, and then a beheading in Mexico. I meant to say five. Then why did Fox News include what's being called a hate group in the Republican presidential debate? And finally, Sarah Palin threatens to sue over that controversial book. We begin with House Majority Leader Eric Cantor, a Republican from Virginia. Apparently, he was looking for FEMA aid while the agency was struggling to stay afloat during the congressional funding standoff. That's right, folks. That is the word from the Democratic Congressional Committee. It says all the while Congress was trying to figure out how to fund FEMA. Okay, how to fund FEMA. We know what a problem that was. Since it was just about out of money, Eric Cantor was busy requesting a conference call to get updates for the disbursement of FEMA aid requested by Virginia Governor Bob McDonnell, of course a Republican, for his district, which was affected, of course, by the August 23rd East Coast earthquake. All right, so typical of Cantor, he's leading the charge to only fund FEMA if the funding is offset by cuts elsewhere, and at the same time making sure he gets what he needs for his district so he can get elected, reelected, and bully for everybody else. In businesses, we all know who's making money out there today. It is the Family Dollar Stores, folks. The stock symbol FDO reporting an 8% rise in profit for its fourth quarter, coming in above analyst expectations. We know it. We've all been there. Everybody's shopping there. Net income for the fourth quarter increasing to $79.85 million from $73.95 million last year. Then, as U.S. durable goods orders unexpectedly fell in August following a surge in July, we should tell you that, U.S. durable goods orders fell. That is the word from the Commerce Department, and you should know durable goods are products that are not consumed or quickly disposed of and can be used for several years, okay? The $200 million decrease in durable goods orders represents a 0.1% decline. The drop in new orders partly offset by a 4.1% jump in durable goods orders in July. In the auto industry, folks, tough times for some Japanese automakers, many still being hurt by supply shortages following the devastating March earthquake and tsunami. We're talking Toyota and Honda, for example. Their sales in Japan, you should know, have declined, folks. They have declined, okay? They're making their money here in the United States of America. Keep that in mind, folks. You should know that. The United States and Asia, I should say, particularly in China. So the U.S. is filling everybody else's coffers. The question I always ask is, who's filling ours? Because they're really empty. Also over at Google, Google's 59th employee, his name Doug Edwards, he asked President Obama in a town hall meeting to please raise his taxes. Edwards said this about how his tax money is used, quote, I would like very much to have the country to continue to invest in things like Pell Grants and infrastructure and job training programs that made it possible for me to get where I am, unquote. Thank you, Doug. Somebody, please. In international news, Iran says it's going to send ships near the Atlantic coast of the United States, a military source reportedly saying that Iran wants to establish a powerful presence near the marine borders of the U.S. In February, you should know, two Iranian Navy ships traversed the Suez Canal in the first such voyages by Iranian ships since 1979. In international news, the Jerusalem Post reporting that nearly 70% of Israelis believe that their country ought to accept Palestinian statehood if that is what the United Nations decides. That data coming from a Hebrew University of Jerusalem poll saying that if the UN recognizes a Palestinian state, Israel should accept the decision. Now, let's look on the Palestinian side. And in the same poll, and also done in conjunction with the Palestinian Center for Policy and Survey Research, Palestinians asked how Israel could be made to quit Palestinian lands. 37% said they favored nonviolent resistance, while 30% said direct negotiations with Israel were the way to go. Okay? From Afghanistan, Afghan and U.S.-led coalition troops destroyed drugs worth more than $350 million, folks. Also, three drug labs. It is believed to be Afghan's largest drug seizure in the past decade. The money from the drugs, what do you think they're used to do? You know what they're used to do. They're bankrolling attacks on Afghan and coalition forces. In crime news from Acapulco, okay, Mexico, Mexican police have found five severed heads. Mm-hmm. In front of a primary school. Interesting place to dump them. In the Pacific Coast resort town of Acapulco. Come on, folks. That's where we all have gone to vacation. Make other plans, folks. Police say they are not sure if it is related to the extortion threats that led about 140 primary schools in the city to close temporarily earlier in the month because the teachers and the parents said it was just not safe enough to start classes. Well, those five heads dumped in front of a primary school were left in a sack. Any child could have opened that sack, along with a handwritten message that threatened three alleged drug traffickers. The heads all appear to be men, though we know those drug traffickers certainly have no problem killing women and children. In the race for the presidency 2012, looking at that last Republican presidential debate, nearly 20,000 questions from the American public reportedly submitted to Fox News for the presidential debate. Out of those, Fox chose the Federation for American Immigration Reform, called FAIR. That's the name it's called, FAIR. Fox chose them to ask the first question regarding immigration. So you might ask, big deal. I mean, the organization is called FAIR. How bad can it be? Well, what about this? According to the Southern Poverty Law Center, the SPLC, which designates hate groups, FAIR will be included on its list of hate groups early next year. The SPLC says this of FAIR, and I quote, "Key staff members have ties to white supremacist groups. Some are members, and some have spoken at hate group functions. FAIR has accepted more than $1 million, folks, from a racist foundation devoted to studies of race and IQ. That doesn't sound too fair to me, okay? Finally, folks, Sarah Palin. Sarah Palin is threatening to sue over that controversial book, The Rogue, written by Joe McGinnis. I want to tell you that the operative word right now is threatening. She says those claims that she snorted cocaine, slept with Glenn Rice when he was a college basketball star, and had an affair with Todd Palin's business associate are false, she says. Well, one thing's for sure, if they are false, we are sure to see more than threats of a lawsuit, folks. I'll tell you, if those threats are false, we're going to see a lawsuit. So the question is, should we hold our breath for it, okay? Those, folks, are your stories. I'm Carol Angela Davis. Thank you for joining me on this Reality News Check for Wednesday, the 28th of September, 2011. I'll see you on Friday, same time, same place, new stories. Hope you'll follow me on Twitter, Carol Angela D. Thank you so much. See you next time.